In this episode, we're gonna make my C10 go from this to this. So keep watching.
So obviously the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pressure wash it. So I took it out of the garage and parked it out here. So we're gonna use my pressure washer here to wash it off. Also, I removed all the interior to really get it clean inside here, and then we're gonna fix the interior later. I ordered some new interior parts, new carpet and new upholstery for the seat. So let's start pressure washing. Out and made an amazing difference. It's a whole new car. The paint seems to be in decent condition besides the obvious rust, but overall I'm very pleased so far. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna remove the bed cap. And then we're gonna drive it into the garage again. Finally, that awful thing is off, and this is starting to look like a nice truck now. So let's drive it into the garage and we're gonna start working on some fun stuff. So we're inside the garage again, checking out the car, and I'm so very pleased how this turned out. Of course, we found some bad stuff on the body and some nicely done repairs. Also, this fender is pretty bad, but maybe we'll do something about that later. But overall, I think it turned out very good. Very nice to get off the cap also, making it into a truck again. So what we'll be doing is I've already started tearing out all of the extra electrical stuff. Here's some of the wires I removed already. I had a bunch of extra stuff. I think all of this is for the extra lights in the front. Also, there was a bunch of strange lights here in the roof. I also removed 3 roof antennas. So I have to do something about those holes. But besides that, I'm gonna do some stuff to the exterior. We're gonna remove the lights in front. Also, I don't like these black bumpers. So I think I'm gonna paint them white instead, as I think they were on this car originally. And also the mirrors will be white in that case. But besides that, I really want to lower it. I want to do a flip kit in the rear for the rear axle, and cut the coils a bit in the front to get it down a bit. So that's what we're gonna start doing now, with flipping the rear axle. So I removed the hubcap here, and I was very surprised by seeing 8 lug nuts instead of 5. So at first I thought that they had swapped the axle, and that kind of bummed me out because I've got some other five lug wheels I want to put on later on, and I didn't want to change the rear axle. But as I look closer, it seems there are some lug nuts in there, so I'm guessing it's some sort of spacer from 5 to 8 lug. Why they put those on, I have no idea. I guess they wanted to attach these wheels for some reason. But let's start removing the wheels and see what we got to work with here. It's very interesting. Stuck. Ah, there we go. Yeah, it's definitely a 5 to 8 lug spacer. Wow. Can't understand why they would put these on. I like the threads on this one. You gotta do what you gotta do. Okay, so let's get this unbolted, I guess. So first thing I wanna do is I wanna see if I can get these U-bolts to loosen up. But look at this. I can't believe how much dirt there is on this car. It's extreme. I can't believe it. Also here on the frame, but it seems like the frame is like new beneath all this, so that's good. But back to the work on the rear axle. So I'm gonna lube them up with some WD-40. I'm gonna try to see if you can get them off. More leverage. Okay, so looked around on my stuff and I found I had these laying around that are the right size, so now I won't mind cutting away the original ones. So let's start with that. Okay, so I hung up the axle in some straps so it won't fall on the ground when I cut the U-bolts. So now we're gonna start cutting. So now that the U-bolt's loose, we can lower the axle down to the ground so we can remove the bump stops. So I have just put this on the rear axle, lifted it a bit so we can loosen the straps a bit. Oops. Now we got some more space to remove the bump stops. So that's what we're gonna do now. So I went ahead and cut off the bump stops here. Also, I have moved the axle to the upside of the leaves. I only removed the front bolts to the leaves and just slided it forward over and reattached the leaves again. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna install these that I made so the axle can sit good here on the leaves again, and install the U-bolts, and also have some new shocks. So we're gonna do that, then we're finished in the rear. now we're all finished here in the rear. Shocks are there and U-bolts are tightened. So now I just have to do the front.
Okay, so now that we're done in the rear, we're gonna start on the front. So we're gonna remove the wheel. Okay, so some of you will probably say I'm an idiot now, but I'm only gonna cut the coils on this car. I'm not going to put on a drop spindles or anything, because since we're not lowering it extremely much in the rear, I don't see any reason to have some lowering springs or drop spindles. I actually prefer cutting the coils and you get a little stiffer ride, handles the corner a bit better instead of having some soft lowering springs, and the drop spindle isn't necessary when we're not doing so much lowering. So we're gonna go ahead and remove everything so we can cut the coil, and we're gonna put everything back together again. Unfortunately, my battery died, but after a lot of hammering, the lower control arm finally loosened. So now we just have to pull out the spring and then we can cut it. So I went ahead and removed the spring on the other side, and then I washed them, cut them, and painted them a bit, so a little more fun to work with. But it's a major pain to work on this front end because someone has smeared grease all over everything. So whatever you touch, you get super dirty directly, and it's really annoying. But now we're just gonna put this back in, and we hopefully never have to touch this stuff again.
So now everything is done in the front and the rear, but we have to do one more thing, because the wheels that that was on this car when we started wasn't very pretty. So I've thought about what I wanted to have instead, and since this car is a very bare-bone truck, my first idea was to take these steel wheels, but I would paint them white, and I would go with white bumpers and white mirrors and so on. But after a lot of thinking and buying some chrome parts, I decided that I'm gonna go with these steel wheels instead. So we have two 15 by 7 inch, and we have two of the little more rare 15 by 8 that we're gonna run in the rear, and we're gonna put some other tires on them. So before we put them on the car, we're gonna put some paint on them, and then we can finally get this car on the road. This is how the wheels turn out, and I think it looks awesome. They aren't perfect, but they're good enough, and they're gonna look good on the car. So now we have to do is bolt them on, and then we can lower this thing to the ground. So the wheels are on, and so now all we have to do is lower this thing down. I'm so happy with the new ride height. It will probably drop a little more in the front when we move it, but I think it looks really awesome. So let's drive it out to the garage. So I think this turned out amazing. I think the lowering is perfect, both the front and rear. Couldn't be more happy with it. And the wheels look awesome along with it. For this episode, in the next episode we're gonna start making this thing even a little more nicer. We're gonna remove the little bar there on the bed. I'm gonna fix all of this, remove everything that's not necessary, and as some of you probably already seen, I've sheeted a little here in the front and started already, but we're gonna keep working on that. So thanks everyone for watching this episode. If you liked it, consider subscribing and liking, and I will see you in the next episode.